Hey there, Dan Martell, serial entrepreneur, investor, and creator of SaaS Academy. In this video, I'm gonna teach you how to create a SaaS cancellation page or system to make sure you capture the cancellation. Be sure to stay to the end where I'm telling you how to get access to my free cancellation page template. Literally, all the copy, the landing pages, the wireframes, all designed for you using the principles I'm gonna teach you in this video. Let's get into it. So one of the things that are gonna frustrate you the most building a software business is churn and cancellations. People come in, use the product and leave. It's like little stabs in the heart because you put your heart and literally everything into your business and they're just leaving out the back door. It's a leaky bucket and you wanna stop them. When I was doing this for Flowtown, we had 20% monthly churn. And I had to understand how to solve this. I read the books, the blog posts, listened to the podcast, and implemented the strategies that were recommended to get it down to 8% churn. That was for my own companies. And since then, I've literally coached hundreds of SaaS founders to reduce the churn in their business. And one of the core frameworks is the cancellation page. And there's three key principles that you need to understand and think about when you're designing these. I'm gonna walk you through. Number one, remind the loss. If somebody's going to cancel and they've spent time, hopefully you got them activated through your trial process or your onboarding or customer success, and they've implemented information, they've connected devices, and they've used Zapier to connect different tools, and there's data in the system, then when they go to cancel, you actually need to show them doing this will cause you to lose the 15 landing pages, the 400,000 contacts, the whatever assets or information they've already configured, right? The more you can make it seem, or like, you know, maybe they got some value from the product, the more you can let them know the impact or the loss that they're gonna have from using your product when they go to that cancellation page, it's like right front and center and bolded, then it's gonna give you the opportunity to make them think twice. And it's in that, is this really the right time to cancel this service? Maybe I should go work some other areas of the business. Because whatever reason, they're probably looking to upgrade. It's not that they don't wanna use it anymore, they just need something that's different, maybe better, maybe that because it's missing a feature. So you want to remind them of the loss to make them think twice. Number two, align alternatives. So this to me is the most powerful opportunity if you don't have a cancellation page process, is to ask them why they're canceling. Is it the price? Is it the features? Is it the configuration? Is it the support? Whatever the issue is within the product, as soon as you know that, okay, and I'm gonna give you the templates, but if you have a tab and ask them all these different reasons they're canceling, then you can provide alternatives. If somebody's downloading or canceling because of the price, maybe it's because you have a marketing tool and they're no longer using that marketing channel, or they've already done the work and they're not gonna need this for another quarter, whatever it is. So you can introduce maybe a pause plan, right? Where they can save their data in the system for a lower monthly cost that's worth it, so that when they come back in 3 months, they don't have to reset everything up, right? If they've already invited team members, created templates, processes, et cetera, in your tool, you can maybe downsell them to a different plan, or upsell them to the plan that has the missing features that they want. So that's another option, is you wanna say, is it a missing feature? Maybe that thing you need, for example, Salesforce integration is available as an add-on or in a higher level plan, right? So you wanna make sure that you align the alternatives to the situation they're in. If they go and say, hey, you know, it's because it's not working the way I needed it to, then you might wanna offer a one-on-one customer success conversation, right? Or you might wanna offer some training, or you want to, you know, get them started on a chat. Maybe they're having an issue that could be covered through one of your customer support reps and you just wanna start a chat. There's all these different reasons that people are canceling. And if you can align the alternatives to the specific reason, then you're gonna have the highest probability to save them from canceling, from churning from your product. Number three, win the why. So to me, if somebody's gonna cancel, I can't save them, I can't align alternatives, I can't remind them of the loss, and they're gonna cancel anyways. I need to understand why. I need to capture that. And I think a lot of you guys are like, yeah, well, our interface isn't great, or yeah, I know we're missing this feature. I don't care if you think you know, I want you to ask. And I want you to capture that. And the way I coach my clients to integrate this feedback is you put it into the product meeting. To me, if the cancellation reasons, the words written down by your customers when they canceled are not being reviewed by you if you're managing product or your product manager on a weekly basis, then you don't understand the economic model of SaaS, because the way it works is retention. It's saving customers. It's building a product that better meets the needs, because you made them a promise and there is a gap between your promise and what the product actually did. And you need to build the bridge across that gap. You need to fix the product so it delivers on that promise. And it's going to come from the cancellation. So you want to capture the why they're canceling, and feed that into the product manager's conversation. So real quick recap, how to build a SaaS cancellation system. Number one, remind the loss. Number two, align alternatives. And number three, win the why. As I mentioned at the beginning of this episode, I want to share with you my exact template to implementing this into your business. It's called the cancellation page template. You can click the link below to download your copy of the full wireframes, the different tabs, the copy on those pages, the alternatives that I would recommend for each different scenario so that you can make this simple and implement into your business. Click the link below to download your copy of my PDF template. And if you like this video, be sure to subscribe to the channel or hit the like button. If there's anybody else that you know that this could serve, feel free to share with them directly. And don't forget to turn off the notification bell so that you get notified as we publish new videos every week. As per usual, I want to challenge you to live a bigger life and a bigger business. And I'll see you next Monday. Ready?